people who try to do experiments with resonant circuits, and especially, for instance, to find over unity and these kinds of effects, often have this question. What is the most ideal frequency for resonance of a coil, meaning the highest voltage output at resonance? Of course, this is in a certain way a good question, but what is meant with the most ideal frequency? There are two types of resonance, series resonance and parallel resonance. And in this video, I want to pay some attention to this question and to the parallel resonance of three coils. I've made these coils in this way that they all oscillate on the same frequency. And I will demonstrate that. So I have to put the camera down for a while. So let's at first take the first coil, this one. It has a few windings and a big parallel capacitor. Let's see where it oscillates and how fierce it oscillates. So how much energy is getting out. Well, here it is. This is the oscillation at this moment. We read on the screen here two dots say, and the output is 0.2 times, so 0.4 volts, the output of this coil, and it works on 1.5 megahertz. Let's take the second coil. This coil has more windings here and a very small parallel capacitor combined with a trimmer, and it's also trimmed to that frequency. I connect the coil now, and what we can see here is that this coil gives out somewhat more energy. And I want to tell more about reasons, and also on 1.5 megahertz. It's on resonance on that frequency. And finally, this coil. This coil, it has 114 windings. That's a lot. Thin wire, and the diameter is bigger of the form, and there is no ferrite rod inside, like this one. Let's see what this coil does on the oscillator. I work with crocodile clips. That's sometimes a little bit a problem. Anyway, here we have also a sine wave on 1.5 megahertz. And we read here, well, somewhat higher output level. And that has all to do with the properties of these coils. They are all on the same frequency. These units all on the same frequency, but they differ in the way that they were made. And in general, we can say that there is more energy out when there are more windings and a smaller combined with a smaller capacitor. So in general, this coil will give somewhat less energy out on the same frequency compared to this coil. And this coil gives also much energy out because it has no capacitor here, and the natural capacitance between the windings plays a role. Anyway, it's also connected to the oscillator, so there are more problems, more things to tell anyway. So all these three coils, so the question, what is the ideal frequency for resonance of a coil, meaning the highest voltage output at resonance? In fact, that's not a relevant question in this way, that coils can generate, oscillate on all kinds, on all frequencies, say between 20 kilohertz and 1 gigahertz. And on all these frequencies, there can be a coil constructed that has good properties on that specific frequency, so that has a good energy output. So there is no ideal frequency. That's a problem. The test circuit, by the way, perhaps is interesting to tell, is this circuit. And here is the coil. To this, the unknown coil is connected, and it's inside here. I've made two videos about that circuit. They are here. And I will, of course, give the links in the text box. The schematic is here. And there is something to take in account. I told that there is no capacitor here in the over that coil, but there is of course capacitance inside here at the input of the oscillator. Here we have two capacitors and a coil. So these two capacitors play also a role when we look to the frequency that is generated, because they are also parallel to the coil, to the tank circuit. Here are all the properties of the coils that I've used. And of course you can replay this experiment, do the same experiment. Inside here I have five settings, and these settings refer to the capacitive voltage divider at the input. So on setting 5, here 5, this position 5, this is the capacitive voltage divider. On range 4, it's another one. Range 3, another one. And this capacitive voltage divider is directly related to the coils that you want to test. Low frequency coils, higher frequency coils, etc. And for an unknown coil, you can do this switch to certain positions and see where it oscillates. This coil, for instance, here, also oscillates here, because the other setting of the capacitive voltage divider gives it another parallel capacitor. And of course the field effect transistor itself has also capacitance between the gate and ground. That's demonstrated here. Here are a few important formulas. Calculation of the inductance and the capacitance. And here is the formula for the resonance frequency. Also very important when you want to do radio experiments. And of course these formulas can be applied to this circuit. That also means that we can calculate the inductance of the coil on the basis of the frequency that we read and the total capacitance that bridges the coil. So here is a fixed value capacitor. Inside there is an unknown capacitor, and they come together, and on the basis of the frequency that we read, we can calculate the inductance. I don't do that now, but it's possible for everyone who wants to do serious radio experiments. Anyway, I hope it was somewhat clear. It is quite difficult to explain all these things, especially peak resonance. This is of course a sine wave oscillator. There's no, say, spark gap or disruptive effects. They are not there. It's a continuous, it generates a continuous wave. But the effects that I told are also here visible. Higher quality coils, coils with a better peak, can often be realized when you take more windings and take the parallel capacitor smaller. In this video it was not very clear, but when you do more experiments you can find it, that this effect happens. So thanks for watching.